Scientists around the world are scrambling to assess Omicron's ability to avoid existing vaccines and natural immunity. But even before news about the Omicron COVID variant, many questions had come up about natural immunity and whether it's enough to protect those who have it from COVID-19 instead of a vaccine. Here to clear up the difference between natural immunity and vaccine-mediated immunity is Dr. Theodore Bailey, chief of GBMC's Division of Infectious Disease. Good morning, Dr. Bailey, and thank you for joining us.
Good morning.
So a lot of people are wondering about this. This topic of conversation comes up a lot. So if someone has had COVID-19, do they still need to get a vaccine?
Yes, and there's a couple of ways to come at that question. I mean, the simple pragmatic answer would be yes. And one way to look at that is, what's the difference between having had COVID-19 and not getting vaccinated versus having had COVID-19 and getting vaccinated? And we know that there's a significant improvement in risk of future infections and the severity of infections if you go ahead and add a vaccine on top of having had the infection in the past. So that's, there's a benefit to it, and it's pretty substantial for those individuals.
Interesting.
The other part of it, and some of the reason why, is that you mentioned, did you have COVID-19 infection? But that's an incredibly heterogeneous or diverse thing. I mean, some people have a very mild case of it. Some people, when they got it, had a very small exposure that led to it. Some people had a very large exposure. Maybe you had a more severe or drawn out infection. And so it's a very non-standardized thing, whereas the vaccine itself is incredibly standardized. Each vaccine dose that you get is the same as the next dose that you might get. So they're standardized. So there's such diversity within it that people can't just rely on the fact that they had it to know that they're like somebody else who had it also. Whereas vaccine, that diversity is controlled for. So that's part of it. I think the other part of it is that we don't see that boosting effect. You know, and if you see the CDC recent recommendations, we've gone away from J&J. They're now recommending Moderna and Pfizer, and those have built-in boosters already. That's the two-shot basic series. So you already get this secondary stimulus that the immune system seems to want to know that it really should double down on having immunity against this particular thing. And now the standard would not even be just two shots, it would be three. We'd be talking about the three shot. There was some comparability between getting at least some people who got COVID and getting the vaccine in terms of its protection. But what we saw is that we can improve upon that with the booster. So now the recommendation would be a three shot series. And that shot, clearly, that three shot sequence would be clearly superior to having had COVID.
And does natural immunity fade more quickly than a vaccine immunity?
It can, because there's, as I said, there's more diversity within it. So there's certainly significant groups of people within having had COVID, natural immunity, whose immunity fades out much faster than Moderna or Pfizer, even the basic two-shot series, let alone the three-shot series. So that's a part of it. The duration of immunity that you want is going to be better with adding vaccination or getting vaccination. The other part of it is that to get to natural immunity, you had to get the infection, which means you rolled the dice on an infection that's one of the more lethal infections that we know. The reason why we're having this conversation isn't because people get COVID, it's because people die from COVID. So to get to immunity by way of getting an infection really puts the populace at risk.
So last question, everyone's looking forward to herd immunity. Are we getting closer to that with the number of people being vaccinated and also the number of people coming down with COVID without a vaccine?
So, I mean, getting closer doesn't mean being close. You know, we do see headway with vaccinations, but we see, you know, we're one of the best states. We're one of the top five states the last time I looked at the stats, and that was this week. But we see other states still trailing us. And we're seeing these rising numbers of infections and hospitalizations. So, you know, herd immunity is a practical thing. It's not so much a certain line in the sand, but it's, what do you see? What are the results? Are you seeing infections just tail off? And that's what we're not seeing. So we know we are not there.
Okay.
And that means we need to push harder to get vaccinations up to a much higher level.
All right. Dr. Bailey from GBMC, thank you so much for joining us this morning and clearing some of that up for us.
Good morning.
Appreciate it.